Hello and welcome back to another episode of Your Drone Question Answered. I'm John Dickow here to find the answers to your drone questions. And in this episode, we are answering the question, what is the best mapping software to use for drones? I have with me today, Michael Lilley. He is a chief pilot and bottle washer. Michael, thank you for joining me today.
No worries. Yeah, the bottle washer thing. It just means that I do everything here at Wet Dog Drones. From the flying to the processing to the drying the dog off after she finds the wet spot on the job site. So that's where we came up with the name.
Oh, great. That's perfect. Well, thank you again for joining me today. I want you to just introduce yourself a little bit. You kind of started going into it already a little bit about what you do with drones. Can you just talk a little bit about what you do for a living and how you're using drones?
So I currently work for a very large construction, a medium-sized construction company, but I've also got a side gig that construction company that I work for hires me occasionally because they don't have a drone program yet. I've been trying for 3 years to get them kicking and screaming, and it's starting to take traction. So they hire me, they pay me, which is nice because everybody likes to get paid. But the main thing that I do with them is fly maps. I mean, fly construction sites, do progression reports, and it's what I do on the side also is just fly construction sites for smaller companies. I fly for private individuals. They want to see what's going on the land because I live out on the Eastern Plains. Everybody's got a lot of land. When I say a lot of land, we're talking sections at a time, which is a mile by a mile. And I've got one customer that has buffalo, so he likes to get those counted every once in a while. And that all involves mapping.
Okay. Well, let's get into that a little bit and this kind of what drone mapping is used for. Can you explain a little bit more about what drone mapping's for and specifically how you use drone mapping? I know you've already kind of gotten into it a little bit already.
So drone mapping's used for a lot of things. If I was on the coast, I'd be doing coastal surveys for erosion to see changes over time because we're going to fly an area. We're going to collect the data through aerial images, stitch it all together, and then we've got a permanent record of what it looked like on this date and this time. And then we can go back and compare that to previous, to what we have now, to what we had last time and going forward. So we establish a permanent record so that we can see what's changing on a site, whether it be coastal, whether it be a job site, whether it be erosion on a farmer's land out here in Colorado. You can see all that with maps over time. We can't really call them a map. We're going to call them ortho photo. It keeps us on the legal side of things because I'm not a surveyor, but we can make ortho rectified photos.
Well, excellent. So, Michael, obviously there's different use cases for different softwares. And so people, not all kind of drone softwares might not be a match for everybody. But in your case, drone softwares that you use, what are your recommendations and why when it comes to obviously the features?
So as a single operator flying as often as I do, I get away with just using a desktop-based software called DroneDeploy. It allows me to run my own maps, keep control of my data. It never leaves my laptop or my desktop. I'm actually running a map right now that I threw today on the desktop, hence I'm on my laptop. And the reason I use Pix4D is because the granularity allows me to do it from my maps. I mean, when I'm marking my GCPs, one of the things I like to do is get down to pixel level so I can find the center of my point that I shot with my GPS, and it allows me to be very accurate with it. I've tried that with others, and you can, but it's more of a convoluted process. I know that on the lower levels of the drone deploy subscription, I have to pay for every map that I want GCPs added onto. I know at the enterprise level and the higher tiers, that's included with it. But as an independent operator, the solution that Pix4D gave me, it's a better fit for me because it's a one and done. I mean, I paid for the perpetual license and I have that until I stop using it, I guess is the best way to put that. It just works for me. You can have different softwares, Agisoft, drone deploy, add your drone to map.
Were these fairly simple softwares to get started with? I mean, especially when it comes to drone deploy, how long did it take you to kind of get familiar with the software and feel like you could start using it? Or was it pretty simple?
Drone deploy for me is the simplest solution because it doesn't require anything on my end other than uploading the photos to it.
I know this is veering off track a little bit, but you kind of had a funny story. I know you have some affiliation with the Drone Launch Academy already, and you had met our founder, David Young, and it's kind of a funny story of how you guys kind of met or first met. So do you mind kind of sharing that one? I thought that was really funny when you told me.
So David had sent out an email about this conference that he was attending in Denver, and he wanted to have dinner with people, and he booked someplace. It was downtown Denver. He sent out this email and said, hey, if you want to come, there's only going to be 8 of us. I had a food and drink minimum date. Make me a video and tell me why you should be here. And I sat down in the front seat of my wife's car because I was outside. I grabbed my phone. I picked it up. I said, who would want to be seen with this beer? So there's your reason right there. And it was just, I just kind of riffed off at that. And the last thing I said, just remember the beer. Well, it was May 3rd. And I knew it was May 3rd because I was driving out to Kansas. I get this email from David and I'm driving. I said, hey, told my wife, here, read this. And she said, looks like you're going to dinner. It's like, sweet, I'm going to dinner. So I got to the restaurant and I kind of walk up and David's there and Dusty's there. I just kind of stepped in between the two of them short. I said, I'm here. And you look, the look on their face was priceless. But that's how I met David Young. I mean, it was all about the beard. I mean, you just got to play to your strengths, right?
Wow. Well, I mean, you got to meet David and you got dinner and drinks all because of your beard. Drinks, that's pretty cool.
A very nice dinner. And in fact, one of the guys that I met there, we'll just call him Spanky because that's what he likes to be called. We went out, I took him on a job with me on Saturday because he wants to break into the construction site. So I took him out and we flew a job up in Severance, Colorado, which is like 2 hours from where I'm sitting right now. And took him up there, let him fly the drone. He loved the drone. He said, I need to get one of these. I said, yeah, it's a mapping beast. At the price point, I don't see why you would want to. I mean, the Mavic M3E is just, it's a mapping beast. And it does that really, really well. 0.07 seconds. On that shutter. I mean, it's just amazing when you look at the Phantom 4 Pro, that's every 2 seconds. I did a job, like I said earlier, I was doing a job in Rocky Ford today and it was 42 acres and I was done in about 15 minutes. One battery, done.
Very, very cool. I know we're running out of time, but I always like to ask our guests this question kind of as we wrap up with, and you've got an interesting story too, because you've started a lot of this yourself and you've been able to kind of figure out this drone mapping software and something that works for you. What's your advice to other drone pilots out there who are looking to do this kind of work, maybe not necessarily in construction or the kind of work that you do, but want to get to know a software, but might feel intimidated about it?
Read lots and lots. Go down every rabbit hole you come across, just keep going down until you find the bottom. I am a huge fan of the Stoics. And one of the things that I've picked up is that the obstacle is the way. You just got to keep grinding, keep moving forward. Eventually you'll get there. And you know, it's like me and the day job and the side job, you know, one came out of the other and now they both kind of mesh together. You know, I got a sweet gig that I'm making money on the side with that I'm turning into its own business. If you want to get into this side of it, I think your best bet is don't do what I did. Don't take a loan out of your savings. Because I told the guy, you guys can either buy the drone or I'm going to go buy it myself. Well, I bought my own drone. I bought everything else. We're pretty much paid off at this point. So that's all worked out. Get in with somebody that's already doing it. You know, that's the best way to do it. And it's with anything. YouTube is a great resource for all the different softwares out there. David's got a mapping program with DLA that I haven't taken, but I haven't had the need. I figured it out on my own and I'm pretty comfortable where I'm at and it's getting the bills paid. And yeah, so there we are.
That's awesome. That's a sweet place to be, especially when you can do it with a drone. And I like asking that question because a lot of our viewers, a lot of our listeners, they want to do that kind of thing themselves. And that's why they're associated with the DLA.
Don't be afraid to talk to people. Networking is huge. Networking is huge. And you got to keep going. For every yes, there's at least 10 no's that precede that. You just got to keep pushing, keep grinding. Like I said, the obstacle is the way and the obstacle is the no. You got to get through the no's to get to the yes. It's pretty simple. You just got to keep grinding. I told Spanky that on Saturday, I should just keep grinding, dude. Just keep grinding because that's what you got
to
do.
That's good to hear. That's good to hear. And that's valuable to our listeners and our viewers. Sorry to our listeners only listening off of audio that you can't necessarily see Michael's beard, but look him up. Michael Lilley, thank you so much for joining me today and answering this question. What are the best mapping softwares to use for drones? Every use case is different, but it was really great hearing about your use case. So let's keep going with what you're doing. And the more you discover, let's get you back on the program and we'll talk more about it. You can submit your own drone questions. We'll find the answer to them. You go ahead and submit those questions at ydqa.io. We'll find the person who can answer them. In the meantime, we'll see you in the sky.